Ah, nice to see you again. I hope you love Jesus. I believe you love him. I love him. I love him with everything within me. You too. I know that if you don't love him before, from now begin to love him. Okay, and you don't have choice than to love him. So let's move on. I want to talk to you today about Chris Oyakhilome, the issue of Pastor Chris Oyakhilome and the wife. Why the wife did not attend the wedding of the daughter, and what caused them to be divorced. Why they got divorced is what I want to talk about in this video. Okay, I will take you into the Word of God, because everything that I'll be telling you now, you will see it clearly in the Word of God, and you understand it more than what I want to say. You understand what I'm saying. Okay, so I want to tell you the Word of Jesus. First of all, I will tell you the Word of Jesus in the book of Matthew chapter 5. Matthew chapter 5 verse 31. This is the Word of Jesus. I want to talk to you now about Chris Oyakhilome and the wife saga, the issue, what caused them to divorce, and why the woman did not attend the daughter's wedding. I read Matthew chapter 5 verse 31. Furthermore, it has been said, whoever divorces his wife, let him give her a certificate of divorce. But I say to you that whoever divorces his wife for any reason except sexual immorality causes her to commit adultery. Except, I read the guy, I want you to understand this particular case. That I said to you that whoever, verse 32 of Matthew chapter 5, verse 32, but I said to you that whoever divorces his wife for any reason except sexual immorality causes her to commit adultery. And whoever marries a woman who is divorced commits adultery. This is the Word of Jesus concerning divorce. And I want to guide you now. I want to guide you in the path of righteousness, in the path of life, for you to understand some secret and some hidden things that is in marriage that you did not know before. Okay, before a man or a woman we get into marriage, we say I do to a man or to a woman. First of all, you have to confirm that woman or that man is meant for you. It is like church, going to church. Before you become a member of any church, saying that you are a registered member, you also supposed to take time and pray and confirm whether that church is ordained by Jesus or not. Marriage and the church is the same. The first church is marriage. Now, you can't just get up and say any woman is your wife, and you cannot get up and say any man is my husband. No, you're making a very big mistake. It's a very sensitive issue, and it's something that is sacred. Something that is sacred. Something that's supposed to last forever. Now, as a child of God, you're supposed to seek the face of God before you say I do to any man or any woman, or so before you say I do to anybody that you want to marry to. It is very important. You are not allowed to say it's my mother that sent me that said that I should marry the man or the woman. You're not supposed to say it's my pastor. Don't supposed to say it's my friend. It is something that you need personal conviction. You need personal conviction before saying I do. Now, you just heard what the word of God I just read now just said. No divorce in marriage except when you catch that man or that woman in sexual immorality. This is the only thing that allow you to divorce the man or the woman. Now, let's go into the word of God. I want to guide you. Coming to pastors or men of God getting divorced, it's something that I really, really didn't understand. I don't understand what is going on, but I have to talk as God gave me the knowledge. In the Garden of Eden, the first family on earth, God was Adam and Eve. Adam and Eve, they are the first family that God ordained. But along the way, something happened. Inability for the man to close the gap caused them problem. When a man truly do or play his role as a man, every gap is closed. Every gap is closed. Every gap that the enemy or any loophole that enemy will see or used to come inside will be blocked. Inability for Adam to fill this gap. I think there's not enough relationship between two of them. There's no enough intimacy between Adam and Eve that caused the wife to search for another thing to converse with or to have fellowship with or to talk with. Because as a man, you need to always fill the gap. You need to always know that you are the head. God has placed you at the head. In terms of talking, you need to have time with your wife enough to talk. In terms of intercourse, you must satisfy her every time. In terms of friendship, you're supposed to be the best friend to your wife. In terms of the material needs, in terms of your vision, you need to carry her along, talk with her, share things together with her. The moment you did not do all these things, the devil can sneak inside, can come inside that marriage. And this is what happened to Adam and Eve. When the problem happened, God came. God did not ask the woman what happened. God asked the man, give me account of what happened. Tell me what happened. You are the one I hold accountable. You are the one I hold responsible for the damage that is being caused, that I'm seeing happening in this marriage. God did not ask the woman, because the man supposed to carry the wife along, show her enough love, sex her, give her the highest sex that she needs, that you not think about any man, romance her to the utmost capacity, drive her crazy in everything, shower her with gifts, praise her in the morning, in the afternoon, in the night, carry her along, tell her everything about what you are doing, your visions, share together with her, allow her to contribute to talk. There will be no gap if you are doing such. There will be no gap for her to go to anything or try to look for any man or look for any other thing to have fellowship or to have communication, because her mind, her soul will always be searching for you when you do those things that makes your wife happy. Now, I'm coming to Christopher Oyakhilome, in search of power and fame, you are tormenting that your ex-wife, Anita. You starve her sexually. You starve her. You don't sex her. You don't give her enough sex she needs from you. You don't communicate with her enough. You don't carry her along in search of power. You are busy flirting with other women, giving them attention, treating her as shit. She was nothing. her soul had been tormented, had been tormented throughout the time she is answering your wife. Because you feel she's not bad enough for your mission or for what you want to do. She's not bad enough to carry along the vision with you. You are busy moving with other women, tormenting her soul. She keep enduring. To the extent that you taught your pastors to stay away from their wives so that they can be able to do the work of God. I know many of your pastors, they are not with their wife. Either their wife is in Nigeria and they're in South Africa or another country. This is the doctrine that the devil gave to you, that you imparted to your pastors, that caused you people to spread immorality and spread all manner of evil, especially in the life of Nigerian youths. In the life of Nigerian youths, people turn their life upside down with a false doctrine. Now, the woman has been tormented. Mind you, there is a level of torment you give to a woman. She may endure for a while. But the moment the woman turns her back, no more turning back. The moment the woman turns her back, no more turning back. So the woman has been tormented. You don't care about her upon how beautiful God made her, God created her to be. You are tormenting her soul. You don't see her as a woman that worth your attention, worth your care, worth you to appreciate her. She was crying. She was in pain all day, crying. You are busy fretting with the one you feel that they are bad enough, that they are smart enough to carry out the evil mission together with you, until that very day that her soul said, enough is enough. She got you divorced. She divorced you, and you are not even feeling bad about that, because you know what you want to do from the beginning. In search of power, all that you are doing, she knows everything you are doing. In search of power, your movement with women, she knows that you are sexing other women. She knows your movement in for power, for fame. She knows where you are going to get powers. You know, at Oron, cross the other side, your movement with TB Joshua and all the native doctors, your movement in search of how to become fame, how to do fake miracle. This woman knows all this. And it's not the life she wants to live. She knows that there's God. And she knows that God is a holy God, that God is a pure God, that God is a righteous God. This woman knows. And she's seeing that, is it the God that I was introduced to that this man is serving? That the God I know is not a dirty God. It's not a God of immorality. It's not a God that is doing ritual. It's not a God that is jumping from one place to another. It's not a God that jumps from one hotel to another with women. This woman understands that the fact that she is going in the wrong way. She's going to be destroyed. That she's heading to destruction. She chooses to run for her life. You are a pastor. That's why she decided not even to appear anywhere people will see you and her together. She decided not to come to that wedding. She don't want to give room for anybody to talk to her on how to, because she has made up her mind no more forever, that it is better for her to be than being tormented, being humiliated, being burdened with your evil lifestyle that you are living. And she is totally right by divorcing you, because she caught you so many times. She knows your movement with men in sexual immorality. Bible, Jesus said it. Jesus said that it is only the thing that can allow divorce to take place is when a man or a woman is drawn in immorality, sexual immorality, then you can tear that marriage apart. I do say that if a man cannot satisfy the wife sexually, no, finish her up. This is the number one place to close the gap from the enemy coming inside. If you cannot give it to your wife and they are giving it, you are busy sexing other women, and that woman, look, you are starving her sexually. I will advise, if you bring it to me, I will tear that marriage. I will tear it immediately. Jesus came into the world, the one that you people are calling, the one that we are calling, the one that we are following, the one that are serving. His wife, you don't want to hear anybody, you don't want to hear anything. Jesus don't want to hear anything. He knows that the wife have been drawn in sin, have been soaked in sin, immorality, lying, all manner of evil. Evil is heaped upon the wife, the church. He don't want to give any excuse. He said, I don't want to know what offense she might have committed. I came to rescue my wife. This is a true man. But Adam was just giving excuse. God, is the woman you give me? Is the woman you give me that caused this to know? Is the woman you give me? Because he did not fill the gap. He was just giving, God, is the woman you give me? Giving excuse. Jesus said, I don't want to give any excuse. I want to do the work. I want to sanctify my wife. I want to cleanse my wife. I want to die on behalf of my wife. I want to present her more beautiful than any model in this world. I want to wash her from all the dirtiness, from all the immorality, from all the filthiness, from all the sin. Jesus lick up the whole dirtiness and take it out and spit it out and wash the wife and cleanse her and present her spotless, present her the highest model, present her the number one queen in the whole world. This is a true man. He don't want to hear the wife have committed a lot of things. Jesus knew the wife have committed a lot of things. He don't want to know. But you, Oyakhilome, you are the one, if you're a true man of God, you're supposed to say, let me go to this woman and know what have gone wrong or what I've done and ask, please, let forgive me. Let us sort it out. But you people know that you are not from God. Pride have finished all of you. Pride, like your father, the devil. The woman, Anita, is 100% right by giving you a certificate of divorce. I don't expect her to come to that wedding. I do not expect her. For what? Why will she come there? She doesn't want to see you. She don't want to see anything. She just want to be. But I pray for her that she will be able to come out of all the jargons you put her into through prayer, the mercy of God, and I believe God's mercy will visit her. We heal her. We save her. We restore her life. I'm talking to Anita. Any divorce, any time a divorce takes place in the life of a believer, God doesn't ask the woman. God asks the man. The man supposed to rebuild that marriage. Jesus came and said, the devil have taken my wife away, have soaked my wife with deadness, with evil, with immorality, with deceit, with my wife have become a harlot. The church have become more than a harlot, more than a shower. If I go to this mystery now, you jumping from one church to another, you are a harlot, you are a prostitute. For you jumping from one church to another, it's like jumping from one marriage to another. And people don't know that this is a shower. You can be a man, you are a shower. You can be a woman, you are a shower. If you are moving from one church to another, you are already a prostitute. You are already a shower. Jesus said, I know my wife has become a shower, but I will use my love and bring her back home, bring her home and wash her and cleanse her and remove the dirty garment and put her the most, the cloth that is more than gold. The whole world must see my wife and say, oh, is it the woman that was smitten? Is it a shower? Is it that a shower that is now the top model, the highest model, the number one, the highest queen now? Jesus presents the wife that is a prostitute. She becomes the number one queen model. She becomes the supermodel in the whole world. You're a pastor, you crave the anointing. When you see a pastor, you are running away. Why are we running away? Jesus came to save sinners. He came to save the prostitute. The wife is like a prostitute. The wife was just had come like what you are seeing these days. What's going on in the church is not worse than a prostitute. All manner of evil in the church. Jesus came to die, to save his wife, and he died once again now, and he has defeated death again. He has rose again. Watch out for a glorious, beautiful reign, the new church, New Jerusalem. Watch out for now. That will be presented to the whole world, and the whole world will stand in awe. The whole world will quiver. The whole world will shake because of the woman. They think that have died and this man with no sin and quoted with shame and disgrace, and that sin have swallowed up. Jesus have died once again for his wife, and he have washed the wife again. He have saved the wife again. He is presenting the wife to the world. The wife. The new wife, the old. You know, if any man is in Christ, he's a new creature. Old things have passed away. Behold, all things become new. The same church of Jesus will give him glory. The same wife, the same church of Jesus Christ, the new church, the new Jerusalem. Now, the whole world will tremble. We bring double glory to our God. So I don't want to talk much more than what I want to say, but I want to tell you that any man of God that the wife divorced or that our God divorced is not truly a man of God. Even if you are a man of God, you are drawn in sin and you cry to God for forgiveness, God will tell you, go back to your wife. Go and cause that marriage to be restored back. Because Jesus not saying, because my wife is smelling, the church is smelling, I am no more the husband. Instead, he fought for his wife. He handled the enemy. He destroyed the enemy that hold wife in captivity. He destroyed them. He led them captive. When he cries, ascended on high, he led captivity captive. So he delivered, he saved the wife, he delivered the wife and present her spotless. So, I want to tell you this. Understand clearly that what caused the woman not to come to the wedding is because of the evil and the atrocity she found that she knew, she experienced in that church, in that shrine called Christ Embassy. That church have caused a lot of youth damage. Immorality that was going on in that church is great. Evil that's going on in that church is great. Covetousness, yahoo, all kinds of frauds that's going on in that church is great. So the woman walked away and said, it's better for me to go and work out my life. And I see it very good. Okay, so I just want to give you this so that you keep on being told. Say that marriage can never be restored because this man is not interested. He wants to live his life the way he wants to live it, and the woman have walked away. Instead of her to die in pain, in torment, in sorrow, she decided to walk away. And I see what she did. Wonderful. She did the right thing. Jesus said it. Any man or woman that caught his wife in sexual immorality, tear that marriage into two and walk away. So, but I want to also advise, any marriage that failed is not the woman, even if the one is the cause. God does, if the woman caused it, which means the man did not play his role as man, did not fill the gap. So God will always ask us, we men, what happened to that marriage? You are the one to give accounts to God, not the woman.